Good evening. Welcome one and all to Ave Maria Parish. To all our visitors tonight, we extend a warm welcome to Our Lady of the Assumption for the celebration of Mass for Thursday evening of the Lord's Supper. If we can be of service to you in any way, please let us know by contacting the parish office. Please be courteous, silence any cell phones or electronic devices now. Our celebrant tonight will be Father Tony Luongo. Please rise and let us begin our worship of the Lord.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Good evening, everyone.
Good evening.
Tonight, the whole Christian world celebrates what we're going to celebrate tonight. A remembrance of the Last Supper, the institution of the Holy Eucharist, the foundation of our liturgy, the Mass. And we remember that tonight by readings, especially our second reading, St. Paul describing the actual events of what happened, song and prayer. Holy Thursday begins the great journey of the mystery, and we journey together as a parish family. My dear friends, I invite us now at the beginning of our liturgy to be mindful of our own sinfulness. Times we have failed to love and failed to forgive, we ask the Lord for his pardon and his peace. Forgive us our sins and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Praise. Let us pray. O God, who has called us to participate in this most sacred supper, in which your only begotten Son, when about to hand himself over to death, entrusted to the Church a sacrifice new for all eternity, the banquet of his love. Grant, we pray, that we may draw from so great a mystery the fullness of charity and of life. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
Our first reading is a reading from the book of Exodus. The Lord said to Moses and Aaron in the land of Egypt, "This month shall stand at the head of your calendar. You shall reckon it the first month of the year. Tell the whole community of Israel, on the 10th of this month, every one of your families must procure for itself a lamb, one apiece for each household. If a family is too small for a whole lamb, it shall join the nearest household in procuring one and shall share in the lamb in proportion to the number of persons who partake of it. The lamb must be a year-old male and without blemish. You may take it from either the sheep or the goats. You shall keep it until the 14th day of this month, and then with the whole assembly of Israel present, it shall be slaughtered during the evening twilight. They shall take some of its blood and apply it to the two doorposts and the lintel of every house in which they partake of the lamb. That same night they shall eat its roasted flesh with unleavened bread and bitter herbs. This is how you are to eat it: with your loins girt, sandals on your feet, and your staff in your hand, you shall eat like those who are in flight. It is the Passover of the Lord. For on the same night I will go through Egypt, striking down every firstborn of the land, both man and beast, and executing judgment on all the gods of Israel, of Egypt, I, the Lord. But the blood will mark the houses where you are. Seeing the blood, I will pass over you. Thus, when I strike the land of Egypt, no destructive blow will come upon you. This day shall be a memorial feast for you, which all your generations shall celebrate with pilgrimage to the Lord as a perpetual institution." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Our blessing cup is a communion.
Our second reading is the reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, I received from the Lord what I also handed on to you, that the Lord Jesus, on the night he was handed over, took bread, and after he had given thanks, broke it and said, "This is my body that is for you. Do this in remembrance of me." In the same way also the cup, after supper, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me. For as often as you eat this bread and drink the cup, you proclaim the death of the Lord until he comes." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Supper, fully aware that the Father had put everything into his power and that he had come from God and was returning to God, he rose from supper and took off his outer garments. He took a towel and tied it around his waist. Then he poured water into a basin and began to wash the disciples' feet and dry them with the towel around his waist. Came to Simon Peter, who said to him, "Master, are you going to wash my feet?" Jesus answered and said to him, "What I am doing you do not understand now, but you will understand later." Peter said to him, "You will never wash my feet." Jesus answered him, "Unless I wash you, you will have no inheritance with me." Simon Peter said to him, "Master, then not only my feet, but my hands and head as well." Jesus said to him, "Whoever has bathed has no need except to have his feet washed, for he is clean all over. So you are clean, but not all." For he knew who would betray him. For this reason, he said, "Not all of you are clean." So when he had washed their feet and put his garments back on and reclined at table again, he said to them, "Do you realize what I have done for you? You call me teacher and master, and rightly so, for indeed I am. If I, therefore, the master and teacher, have washed your feet, you ought to wash one another's feet. I have given you a model to follow, so that as I have done for you, you should also do." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Our In the scriptures, we can count the number of times God has commanded his creatures to do something or not to do something. The most obvious, God the Father giving the Ten Commandments to the Israelite people in the desert. Specifically, he commands them, honor me, do not use my name in vain, honor the Sabbath day, honor your parents, do not lie, do not steal, do not commit adultery, do not covet a neighbor's goods, nor his wife. Very clear, easy to understand. But as we know, the Israelite people didn't follow those commandments. And neither do most of us. A command is given, and a command is not followed. Jesus gave many commands during the life of his ministry. Most of them, we do not follow. Jesus commanded us to love one another. We still have wars, hatred in our cities, countries attacking each other. Jesus commanded, do not be angry with your brother. How many of us do not talk to family members? Jesus commanded, repent, the kingdom of God is at hand. When was the last time you went to confession? Oh, then this is a good one. Love your enemies. That's the hard one. I'll let you slide on that one. Jesus commanded, judge not, lest you be judged. How many people do we judge at work, in a neighborhood, in our parish, or watching people on TV? Some of us want to be the new Judge Judy. Jesus commanded us, deny yourself and take up the cross. And how often have we said, I ain't denying myself anything. I deserve it. Or maybe, why do I have so many crosses to carry and she has none? Before Jesus ascended into heaven, he gave his disciples the final command. Go into the world and make disciples, teaching them to observe all I have commanded you. When was the last time you made a disciple? When was the last time you made a convert? When was the last time you gave good Christian example? You feel guilty? That's not my point. My point is that there is one command that most of us, virtually all of us, do very well and very often, and that is very good. It comes from our second reading tonight, St. Paul's letter to the Corinthians. Paul passes on to us the command that Jesus gave on the night of the Last Supper. The Lord Jesus, on the night he was handed over, took bread, and after he had given thanks, broke it, and said, this is my body that is for you. Do this in remembrance of me. In the same way, also, he took the cup. This cup, he said, is the new covenant in my blood. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me. So there's the command. Do this in remembrance of me. In other words, celebrate Mass. Eat my body, drink my blood. Do this together at the table. If you think about it, this is the one command that so many of us have followed faithfully through the centuries. Remembering the Last Supper, celebrating the Eucharist, coming to Mass, however you want to phrase it, we are following the command of Jesus from the Last Supper. The monk, Don Gregory Dix, once wrote that this command of Jesus is arguably one of the most obeyed exhortations in history. One of the distinct marks of the Roman Catholic Church is our celebration of the Mass. Every day, every hour, every place in the world, no matter what time, no matter what location, the command is being followed in all languages, spoken, sung, even in sign language. And so, my dear friends, tonight we reflect as a Christian community. We look around at one another, all who have come here for the same reason. To remember the past in time when Jesus instituted the Eucharist. To be in the present moment, and very soon we will sanctify bread and it will become the body of Christ. We will sanctify wine and it will become the blood. And finally, we look to our future, as St. Paul reminded us this evening. For as often as you eat this bread and drink this cup, you proclaim the death of the Lord until he comes.
Before we approach the table of the Lord, where we are fed with the food of eternal life, we bring forward our needs and the needs of all who hunger for God's presence.
That priests be strengthened by the Holy Spirit to serve God's people in holiness, love, and joy. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That nations throughout the earth renew their commitment to peace and justice. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For doctors and nurses, researchers and safety personnel, and for family members who serve as caregivers, that they be sustained by faith as they care for all those in need. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the healing and recovery of all those suffering from coronavirus, and for all who are homebound or suffering from chronic illness, for those impaired by addiction, for those who are close to death, for those who suffer alone, and for all who cannot join us at this time, that they know God's healing, we pray to the Lord.
Amen.
that all who participate in these sacred mysteries will embrace the new commandment and always strive to love one another. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And we pause a moment now for our own personal intentions. For these special needs, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Creator God, source of the bread and wine we offer, hear and grant the prayers we bring to you in the name of Christ, our Lord, Amen. Who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen. For he is the true and eternal priest who instituted the pattern of an everlasting sacrifice and was the first to offer himself as the saving victim, commanding us to make this offering as his memorial. As we eat his flesh that was sacrificed for us, we are made strong.
And as we drink his blood that was poured out for us, we are washed clean. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. Sacrifices which we offer you firstly for your holy Catholic Church. Be pleased to grant her peace, to guard, unite, and govern her throughout the whole world. Together with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Sean Patrick, our Bishop, and all those who, holding to the truth, hand on the Catholic and Apostolic faith. Remember, Lord, your servants and all gathered here whose faith and devotion are known to you. For them we offer you the sacrifice of praise, or they offer it for themselves and all who are dear to them, for the redemption of their souls, in hope of health and well-being, and paying their homage to you, the eternal God, living and true. Celebrating the most sacred day on which our Lord Jesus Christ was handed over for our sake, and in communion with those whose memory we venerate, especially the glorious ever-Virgin Mary, Mother of God, and Lord Jesus Christ, and Blessed Joseph, her spouse, your blessed apostles and martyrs, Peter and Paul, Andrew, James, John, Thomas, James, Philip, Bartholomew, Matthew, Simon, and Jude, Linus, Cletus, Clement, Sixtus, Cornelius, Cyprian, Lawrence, Chrysogonus, John and Paul, Cosmas and Damian, and all your saints. We ask that through their merits and prayers, in all things we may be defended by your protecting help. Therefore, Lord, we pray, graciously accept this oblation of our service, that of your whole family, which we make to you as we observe the day on which our Lord Jesus Christ handed on the mysteries of his body and blood for his disciples to celebrate. Order our days in your peace, and command that we be delivered from eternal damnation and counted among the flock of those you have chosen. Be pleased, O Lord, we pray, to bless, acknowledge, and approve this offering in every respect. Make it spiritual and acceptable, so that it may become for us the body and blood of your most beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. The day before he was to suffer for our salvation and the salvation of all, that is today, he took bread in his holy and venerable hands, and with eyes raised to heaven to you, God his Almighty Father, giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took this precious chalice in his holy and venerable hands, and once more giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. From the gifts that you have given us, this pure victim, this holy victim, this spotless victim, the holy bread of eternal life, and the chalice of everlasting salvation. Be pleased to look upon these offerings with a serene and kindly countenance, and to accept them as once you were pleased to accept the gifts of your servant Abel the Just, the sacrifice of Abraham, our father in faith, and the offering of your high priest Melchizedek, a holy sacrifice, a spotless victim. In humble prayer we ask you, Almighty God, command that these gifts be borne by the angel, by the hands of your holy angel, to your altar on high, in the sight of your divine majesty, so that all of us who through this participation at your altar receive the most holy body and blood of your Son, may be filled with every grace and heavenly blessing.
Remember also, Lord, your servants who have gone before us with the sign of faith, and rest in the sleep of peace. Grant them, O Lord, we pray, and all who sleep in Christ, a place of refreshment, light, and peace. To us also, your servants, who, though sinners, hope in your abundant mercies, graciously grant some share in fellowship with your holy apostles and martyrs, with John the Baptist, Stephen, Matthias, Barnabas, Ignatius, Alexander, Marcellinus, Peter, Felicity, Perpetua, Agatha, Lucy, Agnes, Cecilia, Anastasia, and all your saints. Admit us, we beseech you, into their company, not weighing our merits, but granting us your pardon through Christ our Lord.
Through whom you continue to make all these good things, O Lord, you sanctify them, fill them with life, bless them, and bestow them upon us. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. Gathering up our prayer and praise into one, we now pray as Christ our Savior taught us.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread,
has against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
This evening there will be three communion stations, two up front, and one at the break. We ask you to avail yourself to whichever minister is closest to you.
Thank you.
Let us pray. Grant, Almighty God, that just as we are renewed by the supper of your Son in this present age, so we may enjoy his banquet for all eternity. He who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
Thank you. Friends, we invite you to spend some time, some quiet time. This is like being in the Garden of Gethsemane with Jesus when he invited his disciples to wait for him, pray for him, pray for each other. And we're going to have this adoration time for about half an hour of today. So, and then Deacon Tom will repose the Blessed Sacrament. God bless you all.